Welcome back. While it's been a season of disappointment for the Bears, there is actually another football team in Chicago that is making some waves of a whole different kind.
Yeah, several years ago began as a Super Bowl halftime gimmick. Now it's a full-fledged sport for women. And while the fans have their eyes on a lot more than just the ball, the Chicago Bliss are looking for wins and respect.
We're a very physical team, and, you know, having a being with the Bears and, you know, representing Chicago, you can't expect anything else. Chi-Town's physical, you know.
They wear the helmets, the pads, and a uniform too. Well, almost. They are the Chicago Bliss of the Lingerie Football League, a league that is obviously capturing the attention of spectators while catching heat from its critics. But those involved argue that the main attraction is not just the uniform, but the game itself.
After the first 5-10 minutes, people stopped looking at us in our lingerie and was like, okay, let's see some hits. Let's see if these girls can actually show us something. And we did. A lot of girls on the team have a day job, 9-to-5 day job, and they do this to take their aggression out on the field. A lot of girls are doing it, you know, because they want to be athletic. They want to have a creative outlet for that. So I do it for a lot of reasons. I've always been athletic. I love the love of the game, and I love being praised and encouraged for something that I love to do.
One example of determination on the Bliss roster is Brianna the Piranha June, a Roosevelt University student who recovered from a childhood heart condition with the help of her athleticism and her ambition.
I had different, you know, people tell me different things. You can't play any sports, you should, you know, you won't be able to do this, you won't be able to do that. And then as I got older, you know, I was in basketball, track, I did soccer, baseball, tennis, everything. I just always knew I had the capability, like I can hit someone, I can catch a ball, I can run as fast as I can and do any calisthenic.
And at the heart of the Bliss are a couple of good football men, head coach Keith Hack and a man named Ditka, who is an equity shareholder in the Lingerie Football League.
He wanted to see what it was all about. The same preconceived notion that it was this glorified powder puff, and it wasn't. And he came away and he spoke to the girls afterwards and said he was blown away at their athleticism, the plays. It wasn't just, again, toss right or toss left. This was intricate plays, and they were running it with perfection. And he was stunned. And he said, wow, I can't believe this.
With high hopes of winning the league's first Lingerie Bowl championship, the Bliss and 9 other LFL teams have their eyes on a bigger prize, achieving respect.
Everyone else just kind of has this preconception of, oh, you're just a bunch of ditzy girls running in your underwear. And it's totally not true. After our first game, I think a lot of people said that we were better than, you know, even the Bears, because, you know, we're practically, you know, playing in nothing and we're taking hard hits. So it's very interesting.
I think a lot of people are threatened that we're trying to be something we're not trying to be. Just come out, have a good time, and hey, if you happen to like it, or you happen to see a really good tackle or a nice block or a great throw, you know, say I was wrong. Say I like it, or say, hey, I hated it, it was horrible. Just come see, you know?
Lots of holding penalties. Be right back with more Sports Night.